told you to use the litter box!
What's up, everybody? My name is Scott, and you're watching Kentucky Ballistics. We're back on the range, and today we have a torture test video, but it's not gonna be your average torture test. Let's go check out what I got and get started. There's a lot of videos on YouTube of torture tests, but I guarantee you, you've never seen one like we're gonna do today. We've torture tested a Barrett, and now we're gonna torture test yet another stupid expensive gun that we really have no business torture testing. This is a double barrel elephant rifle. I'm gonna be honest, today's video is gonna be a rough one for me because I really like this gun and it cost $10,000. But I tell you what, if you're gonna spend $10,000 on a rifle, by golly, it better perform. And that's what we're gonna do today. We are gonna see just how well this elephant rifle holds up to a little bit of torture. This particular rifle is a Rizzini. It's an Italian-made gun, and it's a double-barrel 470 Nitro Express. It's break action with ejectors. You have a high-vis front sight, double triggers, and the wood furniture on this gun is absolutely beautiful. You have checkering, and check out this color case hardening. All in all, this is a very high-quality rifle, and the round it fires is no slouch. So real quick, let me show you the 470 Nitro Express compared to some other rounds that you may know. This is some Underwood ammo, 500 Smith & Wesson Magnum. This is a .30-06, and this is a .338 Lapua. And this is the 470 Nitro Express. All right, first things first, before we start torture testing this thing, let's take a few shots with it and make sure it's functioning right. All right, here we go. Woo! Looks like everything's in ship shape. Let's get started. Oh, nailed it. First try. Okay, first test, dirt. You're walking around with your elephant gun and you're clumsy and you drop it. You drop your $10,000 elephant rifle in the dirt. You're about to watch me drop that gun in the dirt and you're not even subscribed to Kentucky Ballistics. Hit that subscribe button. Do it. Just do it! Alrighty then, here we go. Oh, that sounded awful. Oh, just right there in the gut. All right, well that's not good enough. You dropped it in the dirt and also the wind's blowing really hard or something. You just, ow, ow! It hurts, I feel what it feels. Oh. Yeah. Gonna be safety first today. I'm not gonna be firing this from my shoulder. You know, just in case. Okay, we're gonna get this around loaded up. Ooh. Load one in there, see if it closes. And it does. This thing right here is gonna produce some recoil, so make sure she's latched in. Put my little hook right here. Safety off. Okie dokie, here we go. No! Okay, judging from what I just saw, I would say if you dropped your elephant gun in the dirt, you're probably gonna be okay. Still ejects just fine. So normally, I save the sand for the very end. But you know, it's really not fair. Because by the end of the video, the gun's all wet, and then you're putting sand on it. If you drop your gun in the sand, it's probably going to be dry sand. Okie dokie, here we go. Ow! Oh! Oh! and get underneath it here. There we go. All right. We've got some sand kind of in here where our lever is. So let's see how it affects that. Sounds gritty. So we're going with the right barrel. Plop. Let's give her a little extra here. Okie dokie. Alrighty then. Looks like, gritty. Some sand flew out with that. Looking good. Just need to wipe a little bit of that out of there. Other than that, I think you'd be solid. Dirt, sand, I think you know what's next. Oh, that's wonderful, look at that. Oh dear, that is, You legit wouldn't even know the gun is there. And then what if you accidentally stepped on it? That's what I'm talking about right there. That's good and muddy. For safety's sake, I did not do all that with a round in there. So now we gotta put a round in it, which honestly makes it harder on the gun because if you had a round in it, chamber would be sealed. You wouldn't really have to worry about much getting in there, but because we are opening it after it's been dropped in, you potentially can get mud in there. So I'm not gonna use a rag on this. I'll be fair and use my hands because that's what I would be using. I'm just gonna wipe right there. Get her opened up, possibly. Oh, she's open. All right, will it close? Locked up. Okay. Bungee cord, put the hook in, and safety up. Safety off. Okie dokie. Let's give this string a tug. Oh! Looks like it fired just fine. All right. See if our shell ejects. And it does. Both these triggers work. They sure do. Well, we are still in business. I'm gonna clean this thing off real quick. So up next is the elephant scat test. You're walking around with your elephant gun, you trip, maybe you have butterfingers that day, and you drop the gun in a big old pile of elephant excrement. Oh, come on! Somebody needs more fiber. This is pudding. Chill out. It's chocolate pudding. Ugh. I think that'll do it. Gonna wipe a little bit of that off right here. Oh, she ain't opening up too good. I'm gonna put my safety glasses on before I close this thing. Why would you make safety glasses like this? Okay. All right. That's looking pretty good. All right. Elephant doo-doo test. Here we go. Yeah, it slid forward. That is slick. Gunpowder and pudding smell rather interesting together. So, if you dropped your gun, an elephant dookie, looks like you could still use it. Oh yeah. All right, time for one more test. So it's pretty common to lean your gun up against a tree or a truck or something like that, and the gun ends up falling over. Well, what if that happened and you were a little bit forgetful that day and then you run over it?
Well, there it went. I felt it.
Okie dokie, well, let's check it out. Rear sight did not break off, and neither did the front sight. Doesn't look like the barrel's bent or anything like that. See if it opens. Opens good, closes good, triggers work. Only one way to truly find out though. Well, if those barrels are bent in any way, we're about to find out. Here we go. I need a tighter bungee cord. That was the right barrel. I am not seeing anything that looks abnormal. Ends of the barrel still look good. It looked like anything split. Eject's good. Let's test out the left barrel. Last one, here we go. Whoop, whoop, go! Check it out. That held in there pretty good that time. So that was the left barrel. Everything looks pretty normal here. Not seeing any cracks or separation or end of the barrel looks good. Solid. So I'm gonna give the elephant rifle a pass for the torture test, but I feel like it should probably also be tested in a little more of a, you know, extreme fashion. If you get this video to 100,000 likes, well, see what I can do. Well, that's gonna be it for today's video. I hope you enjoyed it. What did you think about the elephant rifle torture test? Let me know in the comment section down below. If you enjoyed today's video, do me a big favor and give it a like. And if you're not subscribed to Kentucky Ballistics, do yourself a favor and hit that subscribe button. Also, be sure and check me out on Kentucky Customs, Kentucky Ballistics Shorts, Patreon, Facebook, Instagram, and Twitter. Links to all those can be found in the description down below, along with a link to KentuckyBallistics.com, just in case you want to pick up a shirt. And as always, my name is Scott. Thank you so much for watching Kentucky Ballistics. I'll see you next time.